I'm Craig.
And this is the Wizard Product Review on this week's show.
Then what are you doing, mate?
It's my new act. This is the way to go, man.
Stick to magic.
How hard can it be? Next year, I'm coming back. We're going to have two keyboards. I'm getting lessons off my auntie Kirsty. It's going to be great. First up this week is Rattled by Dan House.
You're too late. Me and Matthew already looked at this.
Oh, that was a... You need the professional approach to it. You know, this is... that guy with a mask on. You're never going to fill in for me, Matthew. A few more years, then he might get there. This really is good, isn't it? It really is
this
good.
Is when I looked at it with Matthew, I literally... It had come in that morning and we just looked at it. I've now had a chance to properly look at it. I've worked it in a couple of residences. And I can tell you guys immediately straight up, this is awesome.
It's Worker of the Week, isn't it? We're giving it. Of course it's going to get Worker of the Week. It's absolutely
fantastic.
If it
wasn't for a little thing called Chop, I think this would probably be the best product of the year right now.
You're slightly biased, though.
I am slightly biased.
I would go as far as saying this is Paul Harris's best release of modern times.
Wow.
You know,
better than Strange Travellers.
Well, you know, modern times, you know, all the other stuff that's come out, The Strip and that kind of thing. I think this is just better than anything that Paul Harris has put out recently. I think this is absolutely fantastic.
Wow, that's a big thing to say.
Obviously, it's by Dan House. The quality of the gimmicks is second to none. You just, like, play with these things and they're absolutely fantastic. Mm-hmm. There's little subtleties that you don't quite take in on the video dem.
Yep.
And when you start playing with it, you appreciate how beautiful it is. Just the moment, for me, where you put the coin or the ring in there and you just turn over the cap.
Yeah.
And that moment, you actually hear even that moment. There's all these
so good
subliminal little bits that just convince them that it's definitely in
there. When we did the special view, look at it, Matthew talked about a cap in a coin in bottle.
Yeah.
And I hadn't actually seen it.
That's awesome. What's the guy's name? Let's give him a name check.
I wrote his name. His name is Francis Minotti. Minotti, I'm guessing.
Awesome coin in bottle routine.
You are amazing. Francis, your routining was simply
awesome.
Brilliant. This is the best coin in bottle I've ever
seen.
That's
another bold statement.
But it's true. It really is. He takes a coin. He pushes it. He pushes into the bottle.
First of all, it goes through the top of the bottle, doesn't
really
it?
Really visually.
You think, oh yeah, that's okay. Because the caps that you've got can be used in so many different ways.
Yeah, it's not just as a rattle gimmick.
I think it says at the back, you know, you've got options. You can do this. Mm-hmm. You can do that. The,
yeah.
The basic routine is that the cap goes in the bottle.
Yeah.
The coin goes in the
bottle. The coin goes into the bottle. Then
with the cap
you take the coin, put it under the cap, and the coin penetrates through the table. Then the bottle
using
goes,
the standard sort of rattle, they hear it, and then it goes,
Then the bottle gets wrapped up.
And I like how he can set it up on the floor.
Oh, yeah, it's great. In the action of taking the cap off the bottle, he's setting up for the next phase.
Setting up for rattle.
It's just so natural. Then the bottle goes through the table, the coin goes back into the bottle, and,
awesome.
And just everything's examinable. It is a brilliant, well-structured, superbly thought out.
You can win a magic competition
absolutely
with that, couldn't you?
You can win a competition.
Easily.
Just with that. That is unbelievably good.
There's other routine. Was it 3-2-1 with the coins on her hand? He's got like three coins.
I really
like
that.
Three coins, and she's got the three coins under the cap in her hand. And then basically, he takes the cap away, puts it on another guy's hand, and gets her to imagine three coins in front of them.
Yep.
Using like a little bit of equivocation, she chooses one of the coins. Yep. That coin then vanishes from her hand. And remember, she's just picked it. She's just chosen it.
Yep.
And the other guy lifts off the cap. So,
and the way
and it's
that
now
he,
on his
the
hand.
Way he's routined it
awesome.
To steal the coin out of her hand is brilliant. It's just fantastic. It's
the bit,
really good.
The bit with the ringer, he does a routine with Ringer where he puts the spectator's ring under the cap. You can hear the ring. And then he kind of does this movement where he goes, it comes up through the top. We didn't like that, did we?
What's all that about, Dan? Come on, what's this?
It could have been a little bit better, I think, for me. For us, it's only our opinion.
No, I agree.
We kind of discussed this, didn't we? That it would have been a lot nicer to first put it under the cap with the ring. They see it under there. Then put it in there again.
Yeah.
They hear it. And then go, did you see it go? Turn it over, and you just go, back on my finger. Instead, he kind of trivialises it and makes it a little bit more of a magic trick. But really, it's not about the routines on the DVDs.
If you had it jump back on the finger like that, can you imagine then going into Garrett Thomas's ring finger or David J's ringmaster routine?
Absolutely.
Having that as the first phase, it'd be unbelievable.
The thing is, the gimmicks are second to none. Once you get it out, you're playing with it all the time. You're going to come up with your own ideas. The routines on the DVD are very good
Talking
anyway.
About that, Dave, I think that this is going to become a standard prop amongst magicians. I'm talking like the thumb tip, and like I imagine that this is going to be very much like in a keto box, that people buy it and it came with a basic routine, but since it came out all those years ago,
you get like lecturers at conventions, and they say for this bit I prefer to use rattled.
Yeah,
and
this
then
is
it
going
goes
to
on,
become
yeah.
a utility item that is going to be mentioned in books and DVDs by other creators for years to come. What Dan has done is he's released into the market something that all other creators and all of the magicians are going to be able to use and really just take and run with it. The ideas that he's put on the DVD, it's a cliched line, but these really are just the tip of a
this is so much so spray. So much more than just a trick you buy for the trick of the month.
Yeah,
isn't it
really
is something that's going to hang around. You are going to use it, and we've had lots of great feedback from people that have had it already.
It's annoying how many one-trick DVDs there are out these days, but this, it's not. Although it's not a one-trick DVD, he's got like five or six things on
there.
It's
quality.
And it's unbelievable.
I can't think what it must have cost to produce it, because it's so, so
well made. Just think of it. Examinable. Instant reset, ready to go, anytime, anywhere. No table required for a lot of the routines. Simply brilliant.
Absolutely fantastic.
Worker of the week.
World Magic Store have got this on a joint exclusive at the moment. Worldwide exclusive, so you can only get it from World Magic Store at the moment. We're proud to stock this. We're proud to have it as an exclusive, and I'm proud to give this 98%.
That's really freaky, because I was actually thinking 90. We didn't speak about this beforehand, but I was thinking 98%.
98%.
Well.
Congratulations,
Dan.
Congratulations, Paul Harris, and congratulations,
Francis Minotti,
for your genius routining. Worker of the week. Right, next up is Are you just drinking that just to like fit in with the theme of this?
Yeah, I am.
You really are.
We've got a bottle theme going on today.
Insignia by Eric Ross.
Eric Ross.
Did we have a communication from that guy
once?
Yes,
Eric Ross sent us an email once saying that he didn't want to have anything to do with us, and if we ever met him, we'd be in trouble.
It wouldn't be nice for us.
No.
Well,
hi, Eric.
It's great to get your next product for review, Eric. And
just to
prove that there's no bias on the Wizard product review, no bias at all. I actually quite like this.
Yeah, it's not bad. It's not going to set the world on fire. He liked it more than I did, but I still thought it was okay.
It's kind of like a revelation of a playing card, nothing new there. But
no.
I can see this working in a nice, relaxed drink environment. Mm. It's the sort of thing, I used to have a residency and like the bar staff and barman used to set things up for me every now and then. You know, like card in bottle, that kind of thing. They used to work with me on a few things. And I can see me using this. Basically, you get labels, custom printed labels. The quality of the labels is very, very good.
It looks like a label should look.
And obviously, at a subliminal glance, you would think that said Coca-Cola if you'd got that on one of the glass bottles, and you can leave that on the side. I actually thought about taking this to the next level as part of a routine.
Okay.
And we had a chat about this morning, didn't we?
You want me to, yeah.
Sort of showing a Coke bottle at the start and actually showing the label so it says Coca-Cola. And explain to the spectator that there was this rumour years ago that every bottle of Coke had a small amount of cocaine in there. Obviously, this isn't true, but people thought that it had a small amount of cocaine in there, hence the name Coke, and it made people slightly addictive to it and slightly hallucinogenic. You then put your bottle on the side. This was my idea for a routine. This is not in Eric's booklet, but you leave it on the side for your barman to do, you know, his thing, or a mate at a bar or something like
and
that.
He's already said to me he wants me to go and help him switch bottles.
Choose the eight of clubs, and then you just pick up the bottle and wave it in front of their eyes, and they visually see it change, and obviously it's fixed on there. Kind of like a modern-day version of Tricycle.
And Tricycle was excellent. You know what I think? I think that you are rare amongst magicians in the, I know you, and you will go to any length to create that moment of astonishment for your audience.
Yeah.
A lot of working pros aren't going to want to hook up with the barman and do that sort of stuff and carry a bottle around with them. But I know that you would
You can just do it. And like he says in the instructions, just hand over his soda.
And you know what? For an amateur or hobbyist, we always talk about amateur and hobbyist on the show. This is absolutely perfect. You could have it filled with Coke, have it in your house so that when someone comes around, you can say, hey, grab that bottle of Coke for me. They grab it out. They're not going to think that there's anything wrong with
it. It's all subliminal. You do see Coca-Cola, and then you do think
and
that it changes.
You actually get quite a few. You get four gimmicks. You get
two Coca-Cola gimmicks.
And you get two Mountain Dew. And the Mountain Dew is set up slightly differently for a different revelation, a more visual revelation. You know what I...
So you can see it actually change as you're shaking it.
I tell you what would be quite
nice.
Not
sure about that.
Eric actually says in the instructions that you can get refill packs on his website or from various places. I think if you could get the refills at a decent price, this would make a fantastic giveaway.
A fantastic giveaway, absolutely.
It would be a really good giveaway. If the refills are a good price, I think this as a giveaway would be awesome. Really good.
I did like this. And also, he's done it with the blessing of Coca-Cola and Pepsi Cola. They've given him permission to do it, which I think is great. Mm-hmm. You know, you're not going to get in trouble if you ever want to use these on TV or in a promotional video or something like that. I really like this.
Yeah.
Eric Ross. 89%.
Yeah, I'm going to give you 85%. Well done, Eric.
Buy us a drink in Vegas.
We'll see you at Magic Live.
Right, it's been a while since we had our birthday now.
Sorry that we didn't do it straight away. Dave was busy, obviously, as you all know now. Dave was absolutely in on it.
But this is absolutely fair. What we've done, we've got about 30 in here, but we had hundreds and hundreds of comments. We've written down sort of 30 at random, going from page to page to page on the YouTube channel and the Facebook thing. And do you want to dive in there and get one of those?
Here we go. It's 181 Houdini.
Is that a YouTube name, John, is it? Or Facebook?
YouTube.
So it's somebody with the YouTube screen name, 181 Houdini.
You've won the big prize. Please get in touch with us.
Get in touch with us.
As soon as possible. We've got that big £500,000 worth of prizes.
So much.
Winging its way to you.
And thank you to everybody that left us a comment for our birthday.
And I hope you're enjoying Flash.
What are we doing next? I've completely lost the plot
there.
Here.
Render.
God, this looks amazing.
Well, have you seen the
absolutely
trailer?
Absolutely incredible. This is beautiful magic at its best.
Basically, you take a phone.
Yeah.
And there might be, for example, you might take a picture of some.
You
skittles.
Might be out. You might be out on a walk. And
take a picture of some.
See
leaves.
Some lovely leaves. take a picture of some leaves and go, hey, look at these leaves pictures.
And then you can make the leaf come to life.
And then the leaf becomes real.
It's the stuff that dreams are made of.
It really is. It looks absolutely incredible.
Yes.
And what else? Things with the coin.
You know?
And the coin appears so flawlessly on top of there. And, because he's got this lovely soundtrack to it, you don't hear any clanging
clunk,
noise.
Clunk
as it clunk. Dents the top of your iPhone screen.
Well, yeah. Do you want me to tell you what I think of this?
Well, you can do if you like.
Well, first of all, Well, first of all, let me tell you, this doesn't work very well. First of all, they've got to be looking straight down on it, right?
Yeah, you can actually, you know the invisible gimmick?
It's not invisible.
It's not invisible.
Sorry, Sean, your invisible gimmick is crap, okay? It's not invisible. You can see.
You can see it.
It's actually a visible gimmick, okay?
We actually were in here. We set it up. We actually did get it set up. We walked around. We were like, I can't see it now.
Yeah,
we're I can't actually, actually see it. No, just keep your hands still, and then I can't see it. Oh, no, I saw it there.
Now, the thing
flashed
is, if people were further back, they wouldn't be able to see it, but then there's another issue, because then they can
see
the gimmick
coming into view. Yeah, you've got to look straight down on it.
And the other thing is, the lighting conditions aren't very good. It doesn't work. That's the main problem with it. It just doesn't work.
All that aside, though, Craig, can I just say, all that aside, come on, look, credit where it's due, come on. That bit with the origami bird is just beautiful,
mm-hmm.
where you've got the piece of paper and mm-hmm. it folds up and mm-hmm. then awesome, it's like the origami crane and mm-hmm. then it just appears. That's brilliant. That mm-hmm. that is awesome. Credit where it's due. Come on.
Yep. Do you want to know what I think of that?
What?
Sean Scott, you're an idiot.
What?
Simple as that. He's an idiot. What he's done is he's put this wonderful trailer together with a whole bunch of different stuff on it. He's put the origami thing.
But
you know the
awesome.
Origami bird?
That's awesome. Why
you can't
an idiot?
Do it.
What do you mean? I don't understand.
No, let me explain why you can't do it, right? Because when you go onto the actual DVD and you've learned how to do it, right?
Yeah.
You go to the section where he talks about the origami bird.
Yeah.
And he says, you need this video file. You can purchase this for $10 directly from my website.
That's not on there.
You've got to buy it for $10. You've got to buy the video file. And then you know the coin thing you were talking about.
It's on the trailer.
You know the coin thing.
It's on the trailer.
I know. And you know the coin thing that's on the trailer?
Yeah.
You've got to buy that off the App Store on Apple as well. It's called Marv's Magic Coin or something. You've
got
to buy that. No, it's not on there. What he's done is he's put this trailer together with all these wonderful magic moments that you then have to go and pay extra money to be able to use.
But that's what magicians do.
And you know what? People are going on the Magic Cafe.
You watch the trailer and you go, I want to be able to do that. I'm buying that.
Yeah, exactly. Well, it gets better because people are going on the Magic Cafe, right? And they're arguing back and forth with him. Here's a tip, Scott. Here's a tip. You know, learn some freaking customer service, why don't you? Because if people come on the cafe, your customers are genuinely concerned, and you're going, whoa, back up the truck, back up the truck yourself. Good grief. They're coming on with a genuine concern. And you know what he's turning around to them and saying?
No.
People don't watch the video promos. People don't watch the video promos. What people do is they just go on the ad copy. That's all they do. They just go on the ad copy. That's absolutely rubbish.
That's
they
what
don't
people
go
do.
On the ad copy. They don't go on the ad copy. They go on the trailer. If you've put something on the trailer, if you've put something on there like the origami thing, if you've put something on there like the coin thing, you owe it to your customers to have it on the DVD. You can't then go and charge them extra. That is absolute rubbish.
So can
absolute rubbish.
Can I just clarify?
Yeah.
The thing I like the most isn't on there.
No.
It's not on there.
It's not on there. You have to pay $10. But then even if you did buy it, you wouldn't be able to do it because everybody would see the gimmick. And here's the other thing. He's put a little thing at the beginning of the DVD saying that if you buy
it's all right.
this DVD...
It's all right. No, because you can get something off it and then I'll sell it.
Mm-mm. No, because he's put this thing. Remember with the Red Mirror thing and you were really annoyed?
Yeah.
Right, he's put a similar thing on there.
Right.
He said that if you sell this DVD to anybody...
I can't sell it.
You can sell it, but then you lose your performance rights.
You're
no longer allowed
to
perform any of the
what
material.
What happens if you do it?
Well, I imagine he'll come knocking on your door and go, oi, give me £10.
Back up the truck.
Yeah, which means if you've gone off and you've bought his little origami clip, you can't perform it anymore, even if you bought the origami clip, because you sold the DVD. That's why he's an idiot.
When all's said and done, you can't put a trailer out for a trick and then say, oh, by the way, it's not on there, give me some more cash.
Yeah, especially when it's not even that good a trick anyway. It doesn't work, it doesn't look good, it looks absolutely rubbish, and your invisible gimmick is visible.
Minus 10%.
Minus 100%. Go away. Okay, so last up, after the lows of Render, we've got Shoe Business by Scott Alexander. I love Scott Alexander. I've got pretty much everything he's ever put out. His 2-DVD set was really good.
Is that the same guy?
Scott Alexander.
Is it the same guy that did the bottle thing? Is it the same guy?
Yeah, that's him.
Is that him? He's brilliant, he is.
Yeah, that's what I mean. He's brilliant.
Right, he
I
is.
You,
good,
I,
yeah.
you, no,
I didn't
did
know
you,
it was the same guy.
Did you
I've seen the video, like him like doing it. I didn't
no,
think
he's
it was
changed
the same
his hair
guy.
Now. He's not got spiky blonde hair. He's now changed
oh, right,
his hair.
Yeah.
You can relate to that.
He did like a Teens Box presentation.
Yeah,
that's
on his DVD set. And he did a Coins Across.
With a hand
and at the end, coffee appeared. He's got some really nice stuff.
He's a clever bloke. I honestly didn't know it was him on the video.
Seriously?
No, he looks totally different.
No, yeah, it's him. It's just completely changed.
It's really good. This is like a vanishing bandana.
He
effect.
Has gone and made vanishing bandana cool. Vanishing bandana, the reason so many pros use it is because it is a time-tested routine.
It is
guaranteed.
Even Copperfield used it.
Yeah, it's a funny routine.
He had a borrowed handbag from a member of the audience when he did it.
I remember seeing a version of it done at one of the IBM conventions.
Yeah.
And the compere, he actually did the vanishing bandana, but he did it for real. It was really funny. So, you know, he actually... It doesn't matter, forget it. It was funny.
You had to be there,
but it was funny.
This, basically, is the same thing. He rings up and says, let's learn a magic trick. You go through to the Acme Magic Company. There's a few gags
at
the start.
It's a practical joke, isn't it?
Yeah, there's a few gags at the start that I don't think would translate to a British audience, but you could soon edit those out. I didn't like those gags.
No.
But 80% of the MP3 file you get is very,
so
very
funny.
Good. Very
basically,
funny.
It's all about, he's ringing a practical joke hotline up and he's like, let's learn a practical joke together.
And it's all the usual,
yeah,
you know, remember
so
palming.
Funny.
It's very similar to the...
But bought bang up to date.
You do get a very nice gimmick with it. And the effect
very nice.
Is very, very clean indeed. Empty glass gets palmed in and out and then it's left on the side. You've got that lovely moment where you pour the drink in. The drink gets poured into the shoe, and then the presenter realises that, I should have left the glass in there. And then what he does for the finale, he puts the glass back inside, makes a magical gesture. The glass then comes out full of liquid, and then he's got a very nice applause cue with a bit of confetti if you want to use like a snowstorm load at the end.
Yeah.
A very, very solid routine.
It really is.
The gimmick's
really
very nicely made. There's a full performance script on there.
I think this is a worker. If you're a kids magician, I think this will go straight into a kids act. If you're a parlor magician, a cabaret magician, you even talked about putting in an illusion show.
I actually seriously would think about doing this, an illusion show, getting a kid to come out and getting the kid to go and then borrow a shoe off somebody.
Because you do that in a couple of different...
Yeah, absolutely. Front of cloth things, they are essential for illusion shows. And this is very, very strong magic.
Yeah.
It's a great effect. I really, really like this. I tell you what, if this wasn't on a show with Rattled, I would probably be giving this Worker of the Week. I do think this is excellent.
Yeah.
I'm giving it 94%.
you know, I think this is probably going to get about 96% off me. I think that this is going to sell like hotcakes, because everybody that's got the Vanishing Bandana is now going to go and buy this and upgrade it and bring their act up into the 21st century.
It's absolutely fantastic.
I know
fantastic.
I'm going to buy this. I want this. I want this so badly. I can taste it.
That's it this week for the Wizard Product Review. Well, Future Buzz. What's Future
Buzz? Right, stuff that I know that I'm looking forward to. I can't wait to get my hands on Sugar Rush by Brian Platt.
Yeah.
Brian Platt, awesome magician.
I'm looking forward to J.C. Sum's Illusion DVD.
Really? I heard that he does a vanishing organ.
Right, okay.
Vanishing piano on there.
I definitely need that one then. There's a few things, his motorcycle and that kind of thing. Really looking forward to having a look at those. JC's already messaged me on Facebook to say they are on the way over for review, so I'm really looking forward to
that. And the other thing I'm looking forward to is Tool by the legend that is David Stone. David hasn't messaged me on Facebook. but I'm going to get a hold of it somehow.
But we will get one in for review. That's it this week for the Wizard Product Review. We'll see you next Wednesday at 12 noon. I'm Dave.
I'm Craig.
We'll see you then.